الله أكبر الله أكبر أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله حي على الصلاة حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح حي على الفلاح الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله
إن الحمد لله نحمده تعالى ونستهديه ونؤمن به ونتوكل عليه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمدًا عبده ورسوله وصفيه من خلقه وخليله أدى الأمانة ونصح الأمة وكشف الغمة وتركنا على المحجة البيضاء ليلها كنهارها لا يزيغ عنها إلا هالك وصلى الله وسلم على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه ومن استنى بسنته إلى يوم الدين وبعد إخوتي الكرام أوصيكم ونفسي بتقوى الله عز وجل كما قال سبحانه يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله ولتنظر نفس ما قدمت لغد واتقوا الله إن الله خبير بما تعملون ولا تكونوا كالذين نسوا الله ولا تكونوا كالذين نسوا الله فأنساهم أنفسهم أولئك هم الفاسقون لا يستوي أصحاب النار وأصحاب الجنة أصحاب الجنة هم الفائزون اللهم ارزقنا الإخلاص في القول والعمل آمين يا رب العالمين. We have been discussing about the journey, brothers and sisters, you and me belong to, the journey related to Akhirah. We are not going to live here forever. One day, we are going to leave this dunya, heading towards the Akhirah, and we discuss some of the stages related to death. We talked about ihtidar, the stage when a person is about to die, and he can see the angels of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the sakaratul maut that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam also went through when he was about to die. He has a pot of water. He sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was dipping his hand in it, wiping over his face and saying, La ilaha illallah, inna lil mauti la sakarat. The sakaratul maut is another stage. So inshallah we'll continue that discussion. And as we were talking about the soul when leaving the body, and Rasulullah mentioned in a detailed hadith that when a pious person, a righteous person is about to leave the dunya, now we can see the angels of Allah. Now the righteous person, the kafan will be from the Jannah. The kafan will be from Jannah. And the angels with bright faces like shams, like sun, they will be coming from the Jannah, bringing the kafan for that person. And the Malakul Maut, the angel, stands right beside that person and says, Ya ayyatuha an-nafsu at-tayyibah, ukhriji ila maghfiratin wa ridwanin min Allah. O pure, righteous soul, come out towards the forgiveness and maghfirah of Allah. Just imagine for a moment, what is the protocol as we were discussing as well for a righteous person? Right from there,
Subhanallah, he can see the angels coming to the kafir from Jannah. At that time, as we talked about in ayah of Surah Fussilat, إِنَّ الَّذِينَ قَالُوا رَبُّنَ اللَّهُ ثُمَّ اسْتَقَامُوا تَتَنَزَّلُ عَلَيْهِمُ الْمَلَائِكَةُ أَلَّا تَخَافُوا وَلَا تَحْزَنُوا وَأَبْشِرُوا بِالْجَنَّةِ الَّتِي كُنْتُمْ تُوعَدُونَ. Right from there, the protocol for a righteous person is, the angels of Allah is calming that person down. You don't have to worry. لَا خَوْفٌ عَلَيْهِمْ وَلَا هُمْ يَحْزَنُونَ. We are giving you the glad tidings of Jannah. وَأَبْشِرُوا بِالْجَنَّةِ. So when the person, the righteous person, the angels, Malakul Maut, he says that, O righteous soul, come out. Rasulullah said, the soul comes out as the drop of water comes out from jug. That's how easily and calmly a soul of a righteous person has been taken by the angels of Allah. On the other hand, and when an evil person, a sinful person dies, and again, the kafan comes from, not from Jannah, but from hellfire. The angels of Allah, they have, you know, the dark faces, and they come, bring that kafan, and now Malakul Maut again makes the announcement. But this time, Ya ayyatuha an-nafsul khabitha, O evil soul, come out to the wrath and the ghadab and the anger of Allah. When the Malakul Maut makes an announcement, the hadith says the soul runs in the body, doesn't want to come out. And when the Malakul Maut takes the soul out, in the other hand, the righteous person, when his soul is being taken out, the angels, they jump on that soul, wrap it in the kafan from Jannah, and take it up to the heaven. And from wherever they would pass by, from the roof of angels, that soul will have a beautiful smell. So the angel will ask, who is this? Whose soul is this? So the angel will reply, this is soul of so and so. And the angels, they will call it by beautiful names. And when the soul will reach at the first heaven, the angels will seek the permission will be granted until the soul reaches up to the heaven. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala writes his maghfirah and the Jannah for that soul. And Allah says, take it back, because that is where it was created. That's why they are going to, you know, be buried, and that's from where they are going to be resurrected on the day of judgment. On the other hand, the angels, they jump for a soul which is evil, and they wrap that soul in the kafan from hellfire, and then from wherever that soul, you know, they take it up to the heaven, it has a bad smell, and the angel, they say, whose soul is this? They say, this is a soul of so and so. And the angel also, they take worse names, you know, calling that soul by worse name. And when it reaches the first heaven, the angel the seek for the permission to open the gate of the heaven, but the permission is not granted. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, take it back to the lowest of the earth. Imagine for a moment, brothers and sisters, me talking, you listening. It is for us. It is for me and you. Me and you, we are part of that journey. One day, doesn't matter you are a young or old person. Doesn't matter. One day we have to go through with all these stages. Here in this dunya, maybe there is a difference because of our status is based on the money and the degree, and you know what's the status of you relating to this dunya. But what will be the status in akhirah? Right from when a person is about to die, it changes. It is related to now your a'mal, your good deed. وَمَا تُقَدِّمُوا لِأَنفُسِكُم مِّنْ خَيْرٍ تَجِدُوهُ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ. What was your investment? In which account you were investing? Was it only for this dunya, where you are worried about your children, their education, their future, about yourself, having a nice house, nice car, and that's it? Allahu Akbar. You know, a couple of weeks ago, the brother who died, and I just visited their house, and the person who did whistle to that brother, he was saying, it was a life-changing for me. He was his close friend, even close relative. He said, I was hesitated that how I can going to give whistle to the back to one of my, you know, beloved friend. That was my first time in my life. He said, but when I went in, I did the ghusl. He said, that's life changing for me. And subhanAllah, he said these words. He said, I was thinking during that process that what he is taking with him now, nothing. He has a nice house, cars, everything. Now what he is taking with him, and I'm sure that most of us who also did that ghusl of any mayyit might be thinking some same lines, that what this person is taking with him, nothing but a'mal. And that is the reality. That is the reality, brothers and sisters. And that is what we need to, and that's what we are discussing, so we can remind each other about the journey that you and me belong to. So now the soul back to the earth, and now a person is in the grave. What happens in the grave? The first thing Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam mentioned, and the about the grave, even Uthman ibn Affan radiallahu anhu, he used to cry a lot when he used to visit grave. And someone asked him, Ya Uthman, Amir al-Mu'min Uthman ibn Affan, when you hear about the Jannah and the hellfire, that doesn't affect you that much as when you visit the grave. So Uthman ibn Affan radiallahu anhu said, I heard Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam saying that the grave is the first step towards Akhirah. Grave is the first step towards Akhirah. If it goes well, whatever comes next will be easy. But if the step, if that process in the grave does not go well, the rest, there will be, you know, a lot of difficulty. It will not be easy. The next process will not be easy. An old lady used to clean the Masjid al-Nabawi, and one night she died, and the Sahaba, they prayed janazah. Later on, Rasulullah asked about her, where is she? And they told that she died, and it was night time, so we just prayed janazah and buried her. Rasulullah went to on her grave, and then after making dua, he said, the grave is dark. It's dark. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala blesses with light when I say salawat or salam on that person. And then he said, when a dead body, the meaning of the hadith, is placed in the grave, it squeezed him. Every person. Another hadith, Rasulullah said, if anyone would have saved from that, would be Sa'ad ibn Mu'adh radiallahu anhu. Who was he? He was one of the leader of Ansar. He was the one who welcomed Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam. And when he died, 70,000 angels accompanied the janazah of Sa'ad ibn Mu'adh radiallahu anhu. The arsh of Allah, Rasulullah said, shook at the time of death of Sa'ad ibn Mu'adh radiallahu anhu. So he said, if anyone would have saved from that squeezing of the earth, of the grave, that would be Sa'ad ibn Mu'adh radiallahu anhu. But even he was squeezed. A child was born. Rasulullah said that if anyone would be saved, would be this child from the squeezing of the grave. But even this child is going through that. And that's what we also are going to go through. After that, now the dead body is in the me and you. Imagine yourself in that place. And I should imagine myself. Now I am in the grave. Who will come? Munkar and Nakir. And they will ask simple question, straightforward question, and they need immediate answer as well. Three questions, brothers and sisters. Man Rabbuk, Ma Deenuk, Wa Man Nabiyuk. If you ask me these questions now, I will say in one breath, Allah is my Lord, Islam is my Deen, and Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is my Prophet. But that's not how it's going to be in the grave. It's based on our a'mal. That those answers will be based on our deeds. How was my life in this dunya? A righteous person, when they will ask this question, he will say, Allah is my Lord, Islam is my Deen, and Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam is my Prophet, my Nabi. So the hadith says, after saying that, a voice will come from the up saying, Qad saddaqa abdi, my servant is saying truth. Whatever he's saying is true. And then they say, a man will enter in his grave with a beautiful smell. And the person will ask him, who are you? He will say, I am your good deeds, your a'mal salihah, in shape of a man, and will stay with you till the day of judgment. On the other hand, an evil person, a sinner, when the Munkar and Nakir asked these questions, who is your Rabb? What is your deen? Who is your prophet? And he will start saying, I heard this, I heard that, giving them, you know, different answers. So the angel will have a hammer that they will smash him, and that person will become dust, turn into dust. And then a man will enter in his grave with a bad smell, will ask him, who are you? He will say, I am your bad deeds, and will be with you till the day of judgment. Now, for a righteous person, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will open up a window for him in grave, from where, this hadith in Sahih, from where he can see his palace, his place in Jannah. And seeing that, he will say, oh Allah, start the day of judgment. This will be his dua, because he doesn't want to be in grave. He wants to be in his palace. He wants to be in Jannah. And the evil person, there will be a window for him as well, but that will not be from Jannah. He can see his atob, his end in the hellfire. Seeing that, he will say, oh Allah, let not the day of judgment start. Oh Allah, let not day of judgment start. One day, me and you, brothers and sisters, will be in the grave. Sometime, as we said, Abu Dharr Ghaffari radiallahu anhu was asked this question, why people they don't want to talk about akhirah, about maut? Why they don't want to hear about maut, about death, although it's reality? Abu Dharr Ghaffari radiallahu anhu, he said, because they are not prepared for it. If we truly prepare for it, we know the jaza of it. We know the reward of it. We know what's coming. We know the raha, the easiness that a person, a believer, will have in the grave, and then in the akhirah, and eventually, inshallah, in the Jannah of Allah, where he will be living forever, forever, inshallah. Asma bint Abu Bakr radiallahu anha, she says that once Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was giving khutbah, and he started talking about the punishment of grave, talking about the fitna of grave. And she says that I could hear the sound, uproar of people crying, to the extent that I could not hear what Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is saying. At the end, I asked from one person, what was the last thing that Rasulullah ﷺ said in this khutbah? And he mentioned to her that he said, he was talking about the fitna of qabr, and he said, it has been revealed to me that you will go through fitna in the grave similar to the fitna of ad-dajjal. The sahaba, just listening about the fitna of grave, they were crying. But how many times it happens with me and you, when we hear or we read the ayat of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talking about the day of judgment, talking about the akhirah, the ahadith talking about the fitna of qabr, how many times we are moved. And subhanallah, we see, and this is called subhanallah qaswatul qalb, the hard heart. We may have sometime temporary effect. It's just for a few moments, and again, khalas, we are back to our normal. How many times we observe that we are in the process of burying a janazah? We know a person is already left this dunya, and now we are burying him in front of our own eyes, and we know that one day we are also going to a similar hole. How many times we observe that even during that janazah, people, they are joking and laughing. Qaswatul qalb. And this is something, brothers and sisters, we need to remind ourselves. A tabi'i, he studied he had a student, and he was a student for around 30 years. And after that, he asked him, "What did you learn from me?" He said, "I learned from you more than 80 things. But one thing that I learned is that every person has things that are beloved to him. Every person has beloved ones. But some of those beloved things, or beloved person, he leaves them in this dunya. Some at the time of his death. And when he reaches in the grave, he takes with him only one thing. And that is most beloved to me." And then he was asked, "What is that thing?" He said, "My a'mal. My a'mal." And this is something that me and you should ponder, worry, brothers and sisters, especially the youth sitting here. The most beloved thing to us should be our a'mal saliha, our good deeds. But listen this carefully. We are living in a time where even if it is very difficult to protect our a'mal saliha, our good deeds. We are living in a time where it is difficult for especially our youth. It is very difficult for us to protect our a'mal saliha. How many times it happened, we are on the phone reading Quran and call comes, alas, we. Now we are maybe on the call or doing something else. One of the danger of social media, brothers and sisters, is that maybe sometime we are not pointing over it from that angle, but maybe we are losing the ikhlas and sincerity. What benefit a person gets when he is making the tawaf of Kaaba and he is live on Facebook? What you are supposed to do when in front of you is the Kaaba built by Ibrahim alayhi salam and his son Ismail alayhi salam? Allah blessed you, gave you tawfiq to be there. And you are live on Facebook, maybe sometime for your families and friends. But I talk to many youth and brothers as well. Wallahi, one of the answers, we should be honest, that we get is, eventually we are looking for likes. I want to see how many people they replied, they commented on that. So where is ikhlas? Very sincerity that will benefit me and you in our graves, in Akhirah. Wallahi, wallahi, we have to take it very, very seriously as our parents as well. Where we are heading to, brothers and sisters. The argument that we get is social media is the need of the time. Yes, we all agree. But how about when we do all this kind of stuff? Why not to use it in a way that can benefit us, can be sadaqah jariyah for us? But us making videos on TikTok, what benefit a person gets? Count me 5 benefits. When my son, my daughter, making a video on a TikTok, what benefit he or she gets other than trying to have more followers? Trying to have more people to see those videos. And sorry if I'm too straightforward, but I have to. I can see, brothers and sisters, as a teacher, the effect of all these things that we are involved in now. And you know what is happening now? Even for parents, it became something which is normal. But I will request you only one thing, brothers and sisters. Take one step back. Take one step back and just ponder over it. Maybe that example is not that much relevant, and maybe I should not give that example, but let me throw it. Maybe it can be beneficial for us. Do you think that if our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam would be alive, would you as a teenager or us as a parents, Will we want him to be in our friend list? What do you think? What do you think? So don't you think that on the day of judgment, it will be just like that? Our kitab, our books will be open. And Allah will say, اقرأ كتابك كفى بنفسك اليوم عليك حسيبا. Read your book. You yourself, you're enough to read, to do your own self-analysis. To do your self-analysis, you are enough. كفى بنفسك اليوم عليك حسيبا. فمن يعمل مثقال ذرة خيرا يرى ومن يعمل مثقال ذرة شرا يرى. Any good deed that you did, any خير يكون ذرة يرى, you will see it. And any شر, any evil, any sin equals to ذره, you will be able to see it on your book. لا يغادر صغيرة ولا كبيرة إلا أحصاها. Here we are heading to, brothers and sisters. I really need to ponder over what am I doing. As a parents also, we spend so much time, we waste so much time on these social media and all that stuff. If I don't have phone for 5 minutes, I would say I'm missing something. How much time do we spend on with this? This is most beloved to us, best friend that we have. But compared to it, how much time do we spend in reading Quran, understanding the Quran, understanding this message about which Rasulullah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, ذَلِكَ الْكِتَابُ لَا رَيْبَ فِيهِ هُدًى. It's a source of hudan linnas, guidance for the mankind. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that when the angel of death approaches me and you, we are in a state that Allah azza wa jalla is radi with me. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala when we are leaving this dunya, our last amal is a deed that is beloved to Allah, and we leave this dunya in a state that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is radi with me and you. Ameen ya rabbal alameen. Qawli qawli hadha wa astaghfirullah li wa lakum. Astaghfiruhu innahu huwal ghafurur rahim. Alhamdulillah الواحد الأحد الصمد الذي لم يلد ولم يولد ولم يكن له كفوا أحد. قال سبحانه إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. اللهم يا مالك الملك ويا أرحم الراحمين يا حي يا قيوم نسألك موجبات رحمتك وعزائم مغفرتك والغنيمة من كل بر والسلامة من كل إثم. اللهم لا تدع لنا ذنبا إلا غفرته ولا هما إلا فرجته ولا كربا إلا نفسته ولا مبتلا إلا عافيته ولا مريضا إلا شفيته ولا ميتا إلا رحمته ولا شابا إلا أصلحته ولا دعاء إلا استجبته. اللهم إنا نسألك رضاك والجنة ونعوذ بك من سخطك والنار. اللهم إنا نسألك خير ما سألك منه نبيك وحبيبك محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم ونعوذ بك من شر ما استعاذك منه نبيك وحبيبك محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم. وأنت المستعان وعليك البلاغ ولا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله العلي العظيم. اللهم إنا نعوذ بك من علم لا ينفع ومن قلب لا يخشع ومن عين لا تدمع ومن دعاء لا يستجاب له. اللهم إنا نسألك إيمانا كاملا ويقينا صادقا ورزقا واسعا ولسانا ذاكرا وقلبا خاشعا وتوبة نصوحا وتوبة قبل الموت وراحة عند الموت والعفو عند الحساب والفوز بالجنة والنجاة من النار. اللهم أجرنا من النار. اللهم أجرنا من النار. اللهم إنا نسألك الجنة الفردوس وما تقرب إليها من قول وعمل ونعوذ بك من النار وما تقرب إليها من قول وعمل. ربنا تقبل منا إنك أنت السميع العليم وتب علينا إنك أنت التواب الرحيم. وصلى الله وسلم على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. أقم الصلاة.
أكبر أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح قل قامت الصلاة قل قامت الصلاة الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله